Good morning. Good to be here with you this great and beautiful and exciting morning. It's a Wednesday and it's the first Wednesday in November, the 3rd of November 2021. Just about 58 more days to go in the year 2021. We've come a long way in this year and we've definitely been through a lot, but we are all mostly very grateful. We are very grateful. For we are still here. We are still here. The challenges that came with COVID-19 has not swallowed us up. And of course, the economic challenges that is ravaging through the world, not just Nigeria right now, has also not kept us away from the public glare, has not kept us away from you. So we are obviously very, very extremely grateful to the Almighty God for keeping us and, of course, for saving each and every one of us every single day. And let's not forget that quite a number of people lost their lives in that building collapse 2 days ago. So yes, if you have no other reason to thank God, you should thank him for safety every single day that you wake, go out and return. My name is Tomisi and it's always a pleasure being here with you every blessed morning on the Bumper Breakfast. Today, of course, Maryam, okay, joins me this morning. Miriam is looking quite delectable today. I love the air. I almost want to lift it up and put it on my head, you know.
Good morning, Tomisi. Good morning, Nigeria. I'm very well, thank
the
you.
The hair is so beautiful. I've been looking at it all day and I'm like, can I just clean it?
Someone is even doing behind the camera. Oh, and that's Stanley Paul.
No, please,
please marry me. I will not marry you.
That one bring loves money. Women too much.
Tommy knows that I love money. Mm-hmm.
This one loves women too much, and I'm not giving him any. There's no anything. Don't come near us. So there's no available woman here.
Yes, so it's a beautiful morning. Actually, it's a beautiful morning, even though the traffic is. But then, for the fact that we are here, Hill and Artie, and God's been faithful to every one of us, and this is the first Wednesday of the month, we have to be appreciative to the Most High God. I say beautiful morning to you all, and start this day with a praise and giving of alms to the poor and everyone who needs your assistance. This is to you all and to Paul Stanley Cow.
Of course, the Guardian newspaper is where we begin the papers from this morning. Let's just review some of the stories that made the front page of the papers. The Nigerian Air, federal government disburses 6.25 billion naira on consultancy advisors, budgets 14.7 billion naira in 3 years. Qatar, Turkish, Ethiopian Airlines identified as technical partners, stakeholders split over prospect and priority in pandemic, twilight of Buhari's government. Every country in the world has, or almost every developed country in the world has their own airline. Nigerian Air, this airline that we spent billions of naira just unveiling in the last couple of years, especially when President Muhammadu Buhari just barely came in. And we're spending about 6.25 billion naira on consultancy.
On consultancy. You know, there is this thing there. It's just a pity that on TV, we you can actually analyze some things. And let me appreciate the Nigerian government. But I need, from my own perspective,
just give this money to us.
Yes, give it to us. A whole lot of youth out there needs job. I think everyone is trying so hard to make out a living.
Is it a priority? That's what a lot of people are asking
That's
right now.
That's not the priority now. For now, it is not. Why not look into some other sectors?
I think we're really just interested in floating this pandemic. We're really interested in floating this, this national carrier. But let me take a very quick break. My director needs this break.
This festive, choose joyful time.
Let's do this. Let's get this done.
Quality time.
So good. So good.
Family time.
I got you. Wow. I feel nice.
Anytime.
The sugar runs fine.
Choose fist pumping.
So nice.
Heart thumping.
I got you.
Awe-inspiring. Choose to get lit.
When I hold you,
to go for it.
A new beginning.
My love.
It's like playing the drums.
And to go large. Choose drama for days. Loves.
So nice. So nice.
And your stories.
You.
Choose everything. Choose joy.
Hey!
And enjoy every moment together with DSTV.
Blackbird, are you listening? Little blackbird, are you listening? I'll tell you a story of a little girl who had to grow up now.
Welcome back to the Bumper Breakfast. Of course, we were talking about the Nigerian air and if it is a priority for us as a country at a time like this. I mean, just yesterday, President Muhammadu Buhari was saying that the youth are the most strategic assets that the government, that in fact Nigeria has right now. I mean, if you invest $6.25 billion in Nigerian youths, you get results. You definitely get results.
Of course, yes.
We are, of course, still looking at some of the harder stories. Nigerians pay 5.7 trillion naira for darkness 8 years after privatization. You've been experiencing some measure of darkness for a while. I mean, it just annoys me. They take the light every night.
Every night.
As in, they tell you that they said they were going to revamp and change the cables and stuff. And I'm wondering why they would not take the light during the day, and then sometime in the night when you're settled and you want to just relax, they just take it off.
See, it's only Nigeria.
And they keep you in the dark.
Yes, and keep you in the dark. That's just the word.
When danger is likely to come, they keep you in the dark.
Yes. And I wouldn't know what, you know, I really don't know why, you know, the government will spend so much on power, and at the end of the day, we're not getting the value.
Because
the distributors
are private.
We are paying a huge sum of money
for power.
For power.
I totally agree with you.
And that's not all right. Even when we use all this, their card and all of those things, you pay like 10,000 naira on your card, and before the end of the month, the old 10,000 naira is gone.
It's gone, despite the fact that they're not giving.
So how are you calculating the unit? How?
Don't
because
worry.
That's my question now.
Don't worry,
how
the tariff is just high.
The
tariff is just high.
So
whatever
high.
You buy,
too high.
The tariff is high. Too the story high. Has riders like payment for transformers wires poles persist as supply averages 4,000 megawatts. Fashola Mamman, El-Rufai, National Assembly, others attempts failed to spark optimism in the sector. Grid collapse averages 130 times in 8 years. EDC, that's a coal electric distribution company, blames vandalization of installations for prolonged blackout. Eco Electric is one of the most performing amongst them by general comments, but the point is the distribution companies have really been doing woefully. They've been performing woefully. The discos are the biggest challenge we have as a people, and I think the Nigerian government thinking to review their licenses is a good idea.
If
something is not working
that.
For you, why
yes.
would you continue to keep the person? I mean, you have a staff that is not working. People have been asking President Muhammadu Buhari that question. You have a particular staff that is not working, and you keep saying that you won't sack them. I think two people were sacked of the ministers
last month.
So maybe some heads need to roll, some licenses need to be revoked.
I think that way we are making headway now.
And if we need about one point, I think the president was saying that at an investment summit he attended, that we need about $1.something trillion to bridge infrastructure gap in Nigeria in 10 years.
10 years. How about the loan they are collecting?
It's part of it. You people will pay it back. Maybe people have come up with something on social media. All of us should go and look for 60-something thousand naira to pay the government. If we all pay 60-something thousand naira to the government will pay back the loan.
What happens to the tax? What happens to the VAT?
It's never enough because we are not generating. For example, the 2022 budget, as we speak, the projected income is just about, say, 60% of the amount of money we need to spend. So we're spending in deficit. This year we spent in deficit. I think we were supposed to make about 5.7 billion naira, and our budget was about 11. It was 13, brought down to 11, and supplementary budget. So whatever it is, every time we talk about money in Nigeria, we are not making enough. The point is that we don't make enough, but we spend a lot. we spend a lot, and we spend those things on infrastructure.
And where is the infrastructure?
You're away. Enough is enough. South Supreme Court warns on invasion of Justice Odeli's house. Tension in Uni Abuja's government abduct 4 dons and 2 kids. Demilitarize the southeast, embrace dialogue. It will elders tell the federal government. Lamentations. As death toll in the Lagos collapse building reaches 19 and 9 rescued, 50 still trapped. Quite sad. 6 of the people who were rescued have been alive, have been discharged. 3 are still in the hospital receiving treatment, and about 19 people have been found dead under the rubble in that building. We talked about that yesterday, and I must say,
I have death toll rises to 20.
20, right?
Yes. Oh. Okay, Ikoyi Building, Lagos suspends general manager as death toll rises to 20, family protests.
That's what we're talking about. Let somebody's head roll. The general manager of the agency who's supposed to physically be present to observe what happens in that building or with constructions all over Lagos needs to be sacked.
And it's now people have started unveiling what it is they know about this structure. And this is coming from the commissioner. He says, Lagos is not aware of project designers' withdrawal.
And the man, I have the letter. We had the letter. I think my director also has the letter there. You can flash it.
Yes.
Gerald, I think it's Gerald something, something, something. And this company decided to withdraw because the owner of the building started cutting corners.
Hmm.
So they decided to withdraw. And they told the owner to inform the government and the authorities, especially the regulatory bodies, that they are no longer the ones in charge. But you see, I think if a construction work is going on, and as a regulator, you visit and you don't sit in your office, you would see that the designers are no longer on site.
Yes.
You would see that their logo and their plaque has been removed from the building. That will tell you that they're no longer part of it. You ask questions. But I think maybe our people, civil servants, administer most of their duties from their office.
Yes, from their office. Mm. They now believe in Zoom meetings or sending people.
Will you use Zoom meetings to monitor a Zoom meeting?
Because there are some things I really don't support.
You know, it's a meeting.
Yes,
platform.
It's a meeting. They'll just go
not
there.
Not a monitoring
they will
platform.
Tell you, I will finish the whole discussion on Zoom meeting, you know, while the meeting is going on. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, something reasonable is not going to come out of the meeting because you're not there in person to, you know, to observe the situation.
Even if everybody wants to do a Zoom meeting, let's assume the commissioner was on Zoom and then the permanent secretary is on Zoom. What about the GM of the agency? Why is he on Zoom?
Why is he on Zoom?
And the guys that are supposed to be on the road, why are they on Zoom?
You know, this is Nigeria where everything is abused.
I think most people just get to places, even if they go to those places, the allegations have also come out. The majority of them get to cut corners with the owner. So they go to those places and they're like, Ogasha, but you come in. I'm a munyo. Blah, blah, blah. And the man like, he lefe kinshi. He lefe funwa.
It's about bribing their way through.
Get the point. Let's look at the banner headline.
The Punch newspaper this morning, I have APC convention date shaky, party battles crisis in 13 states, Kwara, Rivers, Osun, Abia factions, others await verdicts on Congresses. APC would give this new car to a careless driver who will crash it, says the GenSec. And we won't withdraw court cases challenging Congresses while party vow party members. And here on the page 30 of the Punch newspaper, I have Amotekun arrest herbalist accomplice with coffin hosting dismembered corpse. And on the page 3 of the newspaper this morning, I have ASO seeks prayers as gunmen kidnap 2 Uni Abuja profs and family members. Odili escorts lampoons masterminds of raid, says attack despicable and shameful. And as regards the Anambra decides that 2021, I have police sound tough, plan lockdown, INEC confidence of Saturday poll, Makinde Obaseki, other governors sell PDP's Ozigbo to voters. NNPC admits itches at depots, dismisses price hike rumor. That's on the page 19 of the Punch newspaper this morning. And also, inadequate troops may delay 740 MW Zungeru Kashimbila project's inauguration. That's on the page 20 of the newspaper. Obi Kubana spends, I love the story, actually. I love the story. And you know what I love about the story is the fact that the DSS son, you know, came out to, let me see.
I think the AFCC bus?
The DSS boss son.
Wow.
Yes, he came out and, you know, it was like all over the social media platforms. And he said, Obi Kubana is legit. Obi Kubana is, you know, when you have power, you know, power tussle. This is kind of, it's a power tussle.
Quite interesting. I saw the boy's picture yesterday.
I love the story already. Obi Kubana spent second day with EFCC. passport seized. Suspected insane woman throws two children into well. Bodies missing. And that's on the page five. That's so pathetic.
That's so sad.
so sad.
But people in the woman's environment would have noticed that she's not well. Don't you think so?
Of course, yes. But then, you know, I think people are scared of helping other people, especially people, you know, that are insane. Because I heard about this story some time ago, 3 months now. The pastor, you know, heals and cures all ailments, and, you know, especially people that are insane. Mm-hmm. And after he helped the guy out of the situation he found himself, the wife went ahead to arrest the pastor, that you have been tying my husband and love those things. But thank God for, let me say, divine intervention, and for someone who is an authority in the police, you know, force. Just that he was able to come out of the mess, and he vowed never to help anybody, you know, who is insane again. So I really don't blame people, but they should have just
reported, you know, to the authorities or something. Oh, this woman is our neighbor, and she's not very sane, and she has children with her. The government would just have withdrawn the children and taken the woman to the hospital.
But another looking at it from another angle, are we really sure that this woman is insane?
But the point is that we just lost two children.
Maybe she has, you know, done whether
she did it intentionally,
dismembered the body, disposed it into the well, you know. And finally, on the Punch newspaper this morning, I have investors reject $196 billion planned investment in Nigeria after our president, you know, said the best way is the human approach.
Invest in human beings, human capital. All right, let's look at the Nation newspaper this morning. And the banner headline begins with victims, relatives besiege collapsed Lagos building site. Death toll now 21. It's disparaging figures. 19 on the Guardian, 20 on the Punch, 21 on the Nation newspaper. Sanwo-Olu suspends the official, promises transparent probe. Suspended the head of the agency in charge of supervision of buildings under construction is a fantastic idea. It is. All right, $8.99 billion investment inflow tracked in Q3 of 2021. Lagos Rivers are your ahead of others. Police arrest suspects in siege to the Justice Mary Orderly's home. Manhunt begins for abductors of six at Shuni Abuja. Woman throws two daughters into a well. Buhari seeks release of $100 billion climate change fund. And fear of another Edo's attack grips Ibarakwa. Police get alert letter. Anambra 2021 candidates beg IPOB to sheet swords. Police announce 48-hour lockdown. Khan, other groups pray for peaceful poll. DMO raises 362.577 billion naira sukuk in 5 years. Why Nigeria sells power. That's there. An insider, the Nation newspaper, Tinubu backs investigation of incident. 30 workers moved into building before crash. Developer of building fear traps. How I escaped from site. My friend came from Abuja on developer's invitation. Those are the stories on the front page of the Nation newspaper this morning.
The Nigerian Tribune newspaper this morning. I have Justice Odili's house invasion. Impunity taken too far. Supreme Court. And that's on the page 2 of the newspaper. Body of sons meet Malami. The man's probe. It's part of plots to hijack 2023 election, says PDP. My father abducted almost naked. Came down from ceiling following intensity of gunshots. Victim son of the bandit attack on, you know, the victim son, two professors, senior lecturers, three family members whisk away. I have also how 14,423 Boko Haram members surrendered federal government. I hope it's not the same story now. Banditry kidnapping will end March, April 2022. NFIU. That means some people knows National about this old thing. NNPC allays fears over fuel scarcity. New Plateau Assembly Speaker threatens to arrest impeached Speaker. Buhari asks world leaders for yearly $100 billion promised to tackle climate change. How government attacked Akintoye's residence, Ilana Omoodua. Special report, how poor blood donation culture endangers lives of pregnant women, other patients. I need the doctors to look into this. You know, I've witnessed this at the general hospital, and I was so, so sad when I saw the outcome. The lady died. She died. INEC ready for Anambra poll. Yakubu Soludo Uba Ozigbo, six other candidates beg IPOB, and that's on the page 25 of the newspaper. Obi Kubana leaves EFCC custody. And I have here Obi Kubana spends second day with EFCC.
So two sides to the story.
And I have on the Nigerian Tribune newspaper, Obi Kubana leaves EFCC custody. You know, I think why Obi Kubana is trending now is because he's one of the Lagos State most influential youth in the year 2021. You know, they dropped the list.
Yeah, that's true.
On Monday,
he got the award.
Yes. So Obi Kubana leaves EFCC custody for Obi Kubana fans. So rest assured that Obi Kubana is very, very much okay. And that's it on the Nigerian Tribune newspaper. Front page this morning.
Well, you see the interesting part, just before we take Kenny's business report for this morning, the interesting part about the issue, the special report there about blood donation is, I really wonder when people find it convenient to avoid blood transfusion when that is what they need to survive.
Of course, yes.
They come up with things like, culturally, it's not okay. They come back with religion, but you know, everybody has their rights, the rights to life. You have your right, and because the person is an adult, the government cannot force the person to take a blood transfusion
because the person
is an adult. But when the person, because I once knew of a case in Lagos here where the domestic violence unit handled and the DSRVT unit handled here in Lagos was a child who needed blood transfusion, and the parent's faith would not allow the child to have blood transfusion. So what the hospital did was they contacted
the government
and the Ministry of Women and Children here in Lagos stepped into the matter, took over, because every child in Nigeria under the age of 18 is actually a property, in fact belongs to the government. So what they did was they took the child, gave the child treatment and blood transfusion, and when the parents went to court.
Some people will even say,
they believe that when you take blood from someone or an organ transplant, they believe that the behavior of the person will definitely come on their child. And sometimes they just believe that it is not God's way to, it is God's duty
this
to
is
save
what I,
lives.
This is what I tell people, that if it is not God's will for you to give birth through cesarean session, blood transfusion, definitely you wouldn't have given those people the idea. They would have conceived it.
We wouldn't even be practicing medicine. As a matter of fact, everybody would be giving birth like goats and pigs.
Of course, yes.
And human beings would just be seated somewhere, giving birth anywhere on the road. But he made us humans, gave us a brain, gave us intelligence, allowed us to use the wisdom to apply to our daily living.
Black people are too scared of, you know.
I think we're just
trying
too,
things.
I think we're too pessimistic about a lot of
things. We are pessimistic and archaic. That's just it.
Not just being archaic. What's that traditional thing that we do? We just do not like civilization.
Yes, we don't like
the aspect of civilization that works for us is the type we like. Kenny, good morning.
Good morning, Tommy. So how are you today?
I'm very well, thank you. So which of the taboos do you have in your area? We were just talking about all those religious things like culture, where they say don't do cesarean section. Monkey for baby money be 30.
Taboos, according to tradition and some history that one had, is something that maybe because it happened to somebody, mm. and then they took it as a taboo. And okay. so for those lineage or for those areas or environment, they see it, they're taking it from that moment to be a taboo, and as much as they can, they try to prevent or protect their people from that scenario. And it's simply because once it has happened to one, the expectation, in quotes, is that it's likely
to happen to another person.
So mm-hmm. I think we should just be careful, be prayerful, and hold on to our faith in whichever way the religion we belong to, either the traditional believers, the Islamic, the Christianity, it, depending on individual anyway, that's what I would say about all those beliefs. Because what you said, what we mean by beliefs is what you as a person believes in. And yes, and whether you like it or not, positively or negatively, it will come to pass.
It will come to pass. Something. Whatever you think about is what happens to you. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he, is what the Holy Book says. I think it's just a product of our thoughts. I mean, the Chinese are very conscious of what they put in their minds and what they say to themselves. And sometimes they say death and life is in the power of the tongue. What you also say to yourself happens to you. So sometimes it's just a product of not being conscious of the environment that you are, and then your thought process, the kind of thoughts that you store in your system, and then they all manifest because that was your expectation in the first place. So Kenny, let's have business report for today. Good morning again.
Good morning. A whole lot happened in recent past, from the Central Bank of Nigeria's launching of the Naira to the NDIC, that is the Nigerian Deposit Insurance Corporation, having to sensitize the public on their role as a risk taker or a risk bearer for both government and financial institutions. And of course, a whole lot happening in recent time in the business world. There have been challenges, there have been complaints, and of course, again, the markets have its toll. We've seen the market moving up, and we've seen it coming down. Of course, the market is just a market of up and down, depending on the information available to the market and the availability of the shares that can be traded. In recent time, we've seen Fourth Bank shares go up and it's coming down. And of course, the take there is for anyone who may have bought during the time it was going up, by now they had kind of gained 100% or even above 100% in terms of price appreciation. And if care is not taken, for that 100% that they have up again, they are likely going to lose again, if only they are careful and cautious to what is happening. Having said that, we will in times to come, I will be having some interviews with some people in the regulatory body in Nigeria financial system, and also a state government trying to come to the market to raise capital. And you may be asking or wondering, why should they come about this time to raise capital? What are they doing? What are they using the capital for? Naturally, we've had cases where state government come to raise funds in the capital market only to use such funds to fund their political campaign. But in the case of Gombe, so to say, it's not to for political reasons, but to develop infrastructure in the state and make life worth a living. That state is about the state that you can say for now is not in any security challenge. But the interview I had with one of their officials will come up sometime later when time will permit us, and also the NDIC also when time will permit us. But quickly, let me just give the figures as we have it from the exchange, that is from the Nigeria Exchange Group. The market yesterday recorded 318.97 million shares traded, worth 3.27 billion naira exchanged in 5,492 deals. largely driven by activities in the shares of United Bank for Africa PLC, FBN Holdings PLC, Zenith Bank PLC, and Champs PLC. For UBA, investors traded 52.58 million shares worth 446.92 million naira, done in 245 deals at a market closing price of 8 naira 50 kobo per share. Fourth bank, that is FBN Holdings PLC, with 30.49 million shares worth 313.8 million naira, exchanging 408 deals at a market closing price of 10 naira per share. Zenith Bank PLC showing 29.89 million shares traded worth 747.64 million naira, done in 329 deals at a market closing price of 25 naira per share. While Champs PLC recorded 15.45 million shares worth 3.52 million naira, done in 26 transactions at a market closing price of 24 kobo per share. The lowest trade stock in the market yesterday was that of MRS Oil PLC, with just 683 units of shares being traded, valued at 9,618 naira 85 kobo. This was done in 8 transactions. The market closing price of 15 naira 20 kobo per share. The market recorded 9 gainers as against 31 losers. The gainers was led by Bua Cement PLC with a price gain of 2 naira 50 kobo, closing at 74 naira 50 kobo. International Breweries PLC went up by 50 kobo to close at 5 naira 70 kobo. Oando PLC gained 19 kobo, closing at 4 naira 84 kobo. And Dangote Sugar PLC was up by 15 kobo, closing at 16 naira 65 kobo. From the losers table, we have UACN PLC topping the table with a price depreciation of 1 naira 10 kobo to close at 10 naira 20 kobo. FBN Holdings lost 75 kobo to close at 10 naira. WAPCO PLC was down by 70 kobo, closing at 26 naira 80 kobo. And ETI PLC lost 30 kobo, closing at 8 naira 20 kobo. The number of losers notwithstanding, the market capitalization and index went up. This can be attributable to some highly capitalized stock being traded on the floor of the exchange yesterday. And so the market capitalization appreciated by 19.1 billion naira, closing at 21.91 trillion naira, as against the previous day's closing figure of 21.92 trillion naira, as against the previous day's closing figure of 21.91 trillion naira. And the index went up from 41,976.79 basis points to 42,013.39 basis points, an appreciation of 36.60 basis points appreciation. Because of time, like I said, time will not permit for the interview to come up. Hopefully tomorrow we'll have the interview where the Commissioner for Finance in Gombe State spoke with me in respect to development in that state and what they are trying to raise the fund for. You can imagine if a predecessor government is owing and to the point that they cannot pay salaries, and what the money they have collected so far, both from the federal allocation and from the market in those period, was a kind of wastage, because they did not apply such money. There was developmental projects but were not fully completed. This was a statement coming from the Commissioner for Finance in Gombe State. And of course, the NDIC also says that they are willing and ready to partner with any organization that will make the financial inclusion to be very seamless and to be well articulated. Of course, they said that whatever they are doing as an institution, they are doing it for the protection of government and protection of the citizenry, considering the fact that they are the risk bearer to the financial institutions, and they would not want to see any financial institution in the market close shop because of what is prevailing around this period now, whereby COVID had affected so many businesses And because of that, some shops have been closed. But for the financial institutions, they said they are strong and they will continue to be in existence because they are there to be at their risk. Tomorrow is the day we'll have those come up in the program. Over to you, Tommy Singh.
All right. Thank you so much, Kenny, for this report. We'll see you again tomorrow.
Have a wonderful day.
And you too. All right, we're back here on the Bumper Breakfast, and it looks as if the business world is catching up gradually. Every state across the Federation is trying to invest more in their local productions and all that. But hopefully, if the states do better with their IGR, obviously the federal government will become less of a sugar daddy that gives them money or bumper.
Yes.
He's always giving them money.
Yeah.
Everybody needs to look inwards and find a way to balance out their, you know, the expenses. Somehow it just needs to be done. Let's take this quick musical break and of course a commercial. When we return, it's less just a moment, and we're talking about men and women.
touches of the fire.
Welcome back to the Bumper Breakfast. So it's Let's Gist moment. It's Wednesday. We like to talk about women. Today we're bringing the men into the conversation, and we're definitely talking about something that I'm sure quite a number of men are going to have a head for this morning. There is a kind of massage going around, you know, being made popular on social media as we speak. I mean, everybody's advertising massage parlors on social media. And this particular one is, of course, is a masseuse, somebody who massages you, takes away, helps you to relieve the stress, the tendons, as a gift.